We've all seen those bumper stickers that proudly boast, "My child's an honor student." Well, for the mom of Alia Sabor, it might read, "My kid's a college professor." You see, at the age of 18, Sabor was officially recognized as the youngest college professor in history, breaking a 300-year-old record. And as NBC's Martin Savage now reports, calling her an overachiever might be putting it mildly.
Like most teens her age, Alia Sabor can be found on a college campus. Unlike most teens, she's here to teach.
Is she a good teacher?
Yes, she is. She's a wonderful teacher. The first question we was asking is, how did you do it so quick?
Actually, Sabor's whole life has been in fast forward. She started talking and reading when she was just 8 months old, finished the curriculum for elementary school at 5, started college at 10, graduated summa cum laude at 14, and got her doctorate at 16. She's also a black belt in taekwondo and made her first orchestral concerto debut at 11 on the clarinet. Now she's just been named the youngest college professor in the world.
Are we okay? Should I go over anything?
Breaking the record set by this guy, 19-year-old Colin McLaren, back in 1717. At first, Sabor was a bit shy about it.
And I thought to myself, you know what? It's been 300 years. Somebody had to do it. Why not me?
You go, girl.
Yeah.
This young prodigy admits she's not good at everything, like basketball. She loves celebrity gossip websites and, by her own admission, can be absent-minded.
The youngest professor in the world is kind of ditzy sometimes?
Sometimes I am.
But Sabor also likes to help others, which is why right now she's here at Southern University in New Orleans, a historically black college ravaged by Hurricane Katrina.
Some people come and they do Habitat for Humanity and they build houses, but I don't think I would be very good at that, so I try to do what I'm good at.
So she came to teach, and in doing so, the world's youngest professor says she has learned a lot. For today, Martin Savage, NBC News, New Orleans.
Alia Sabor, good morning.
Good morning.
And add your accomplishments. You actually were on the Today Show. This is your second appearance because you were on the Today Show in 2003. And so here you are, just 19 years old, making a second appearance. It's pretty remarkable, all you've done. In fact, I was just hearing in Martin Savage's voice, I mean, he is obviously so impressed with you. How do you kind of see yourself, given how it's clear that people on the outside are looking at you as being something quite special?
Well, I know that what I've done is special, and I think about it, but sometimes I forget because I'm used to it, and I don't think about it all the time, and actually sometimes it takes other people to remind me a little bit.
Why did you decide, to sort of be an accomplished young person, starting to read when you're 8 months old, going from fourth grade straight to college? I mean, that's one thing, to be smart enough to do all of those things. But then to decide at a very young age to be a college professor is completely hard to understand. So what made you decide to go and be a teacher?
Well, it was a couple of factors. First of all, I really enjoy teaching. Mm. And it's something where you can make a difference. It's not just what you can do, but you can enable a lot of other people to make changes, to make their changes. And also, I was particularly interested in this university because they are still in trailers after Hurricane Katrina. And I thought that it would be something that I could do to help.
You teach math and you teach physics and you've written things, research publications, research papers with titles like On the Near Field Electromagnetic Scattering from Functionalized Silicon Nanocones and Nanowires. So, okay, I'm impressed. But what is it that you talk about this lovely thing, this idea of helping people and also having the smarts to do something really maybe important. How do you see this coming together as you get older? What is it that you want to accomplish?
Well, that's a really good question. I'm really, like I said, I have a research that I'm doing, and I really feel like I can help a lot of people with that. And I have my music, and I can...
You're a clarinet player.
I'm a clarinetist.
And you love that because it gives you sort of a way to touch people emotionally with your music.
You can reach a lot of people with music, and it's never been really a hobby to me. It's always been on equal par with my academics, but... I really feel like I had a student tell me recently that my story was very inspiring and motivating, and that I should really talk to people and share what I've done and bring math and science in a better way to people. And And I'm really interested in speaking and writing, I don't know, like a book or something. And I mean, I don't know how to do those things, but I would like to do them.
It sounds like you're just beginning and all of that is ahead of you. And I don't see why you can't do any of those things. I really wish you would help us find a cure for cancer and all those things with your brain that you've got.
I'm working
go,
on
go,
it.
Go, go, go. Don't stop. Keep going. Thank you so much for joining
Thanks
us.
A
pleasure.
Lot.
A pleasure to meet you, Alia.